Carbon dioxide is all around us, in the air, water, and soil. We inhale CO2 every time we breathe, and we exhale much more. CO2 is a greenhouse gas which is emitted from natural sources like volcanoes and geysers, as well as by decaying animal and vegetable matter. It is also created by people when we burn fossil fuels, our main sources of energy today. Until we can successfully make the transition to lower carbon alternatives and renewables, fossil fuels like coal, oil, and gas are expected to play a prominent role in meeting energy demand for decades to come. Greenhouse gases like CO2 are important because they trap heat in the atmosphere, heat that is necessary to sustain life on Earth. However, increasing concentration of CO2 in the atmosphere due to human activity is causing the Earth to heat up over a much shorter time period than ever before in its history. This global warming is changing our climate. There is broad consensus that to slow down or reverse this global warming, we need to take action now to reduce our CO2 emissions. There is no single solution, but a technology called carbon capture and storage, or CCS for short, has been identified as one of the most promising technologies that we can implement today to significantly reduce global CO2 emissions. CCS is a technology that captures CO2 from large industrial facilities so that it does not enter the atmosphere and injects it deep underground. Shell's Scotford Upgrader, located 50 kilometers northeast of Edmonton, Alberta, Canada, will be the first oil sands operation to implement CCS. The upgrader receives bitumen from the Athabasca Oil Sands Project and converts it into synthetic crude, which can then be refined into products like gasoline. Using Shell's patented amine technology, the proposed Quest Carbon Capture and Storage Project will capture up to 35% of the direct CO2 emissions produced during the upgrading process. The captured CO2 will be compressed into a dense liquid state before it enters an 80-kilometer underground pipeline that will transport it north of the Scotford site to between 3 and 8 injection wells. Such pipelines have been used by the energy industry for more than 30 years to transport CO2 to oil fields, where it is then injected underground to increase the amount of oil recovered. This is referred to as enhanced oil recovery, or EOR. Thousands of kilometers of CO2 pipelines are in safe and reliable operation in North America today. The Quest CO2 is not being injected into an oil field for EOR purposes, but into a porous rock formation containing salty water. However, the basic technology to pipeline and inject the CO2 is the same. The Quest pipeline will be designed, constructed, and operated to the highest safety standards. During operation, the pipeline will be continuously monitored, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, from a control room at the Scotford facility. And as a precaution, plans will be in place to respond to any incident and protect public safety. While the measures taken to maximize safety make the likelihood of a leak very remote, to limit the impact, line block valves will be located a maximum of 15 kilometers apart along the pipeline and at major water crossings. If a pressure change is detected, they would be automatically closed to isolate that section. Once the CO2 travels from the Scotford site to the injection wells, it will be pumped deep underground into a formation called the Basal Cambrian Sands, where it will be permanently contained. How will Quest store CO2 safely and permanently underground? The answer is simple. By using existing technologies as well as natural geological trapping methods that have kept oil and gas and natural accumulations of CO2 underground for millions of years. The underground formation where the CO2 will be stored is approximately 2.3 kilometers below the surface. This is up to 2 kilometers beyond the deepest drinkable groundwater and about 1 kilometer below the deepest hydrocarbon deposits in the area. Once injected, the liquid CO2 will displace the salty water or brine already present in the formation and become stuck in tiny spaces within the porous rock. With time, an increasing percentage of the CO2 will dissolve within the brine and sink to the bottom of the storage formation, where it will become even more firmly trapped. As more CO2 is injected, it will gradually move outwards from the injection well, but always remaining within the storage formation. More important than the depth of the reservoir are the layers of impermeable rock above it. Quest site has some of the best geology in the world for the safe storage of CO2, as multiple layers of rock above the expansive storage formation provide effective barriers to keep the CO2 contained. These impenetrable seals include both shale and rock salt layers. In fact, rock salt is one of the most effective seals, which is why underground salt caverns are used to contain natural gas for temporary storage. While site selection is very important for permanent CO2 storage, a site must also be designed and operated with safe containment in mind. For the Quest project, each of the injection wells will have 3 barriers of borehole steel casing, each cemented in place. This assures that the injected CO2 safely reaches the deep storage formation and that shallow groundwater is protected. To confirm that the CO2 remains safely and permanently underground, Shell is developing a rigorous, world-class monitoring program. Years before injection begins, baseline information on levels of CO2 naturally present in the air, water, and soil will be collected, and monitoring will continue as long as required after injection stops to confirm long-term safe storage. This program will involve monitoring of wells at 3 different levels below the surface and involve multiple state-of-the-art technologies. The deepest monitoring will occur within the injection wells themselves. Sensitive underground monitoring systems that detect noise and changes to pressure and temperature will be used to ensure these wells are performing as they should. The next level of monitoring will be conducted in dedicated deep monitoring wells drilled to a depth just above the storage formation. Sensitive pressure gauges located within these wells will confirm that the CO2 remains safely contained. In the unlikely event there is any CO2 movement outside the storage formation, this provides early warning so that remedial action can be taken while the CO2 is still deep underground. To provide further assurance of containment, monitoring of shallow groundwater wells will also be conducted. The results of this monitoring will be compared against baseline samples taken years before CO2 is injected to confirm no impacts to shallow groundwater. With careful site selection, safe design and operation, and rigorous monitoring, carbon capture and storage technology can play an important role in helping to combat climate change. The Quest project will provide valuable knowledge that will help to advance further deployment of this important technology in Alberta, Canada, and around the world.